county kids, city kids, all the kids that make a difference is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Good evening, and thank you for turning this on this evening and watching county kids, city kids, and all kids making a difference. There are a lot of kids out in our Berks County area, including the city of Reading, that have tremendous, tremendous values and great, great talents. So this evening, we're going to go right to our show because we have three young men from Exeter High School and their advisor that's going to show us something that's incredible. So I'm going to start right away with the far left is Zach Potter. He is an educator at Exeter High School. I'm going to let him introduce himself, and then I'm going to have the boys, the gentlemen, introduce themselves. So, Zach, welcome.
Thank you. I'm here from Exeter Township High School. I'm one of the senior high technology education and STEM engineering teachers, and I brought with me tonight the three guys from the PA robotics team from the Technology Student Association Club at Exeter.
Okay, so we'll go right down the row, guys, and go ahead.
Okay. My name is Luke Ravel. I am a senior at the Exeter Township Senior High School, and I helped build this robot.
My name is Kyle Nepper. I'm also a senior at Exeter Township Senior High School. I helped build the robot as well.
And lastly, my name is Kevin Creamer. I'm a senior at Exeter High School, and I, too, helped these guys build this robot.
So, all right. Well, that's the show. Thank you for watching. But no, it's really interesting to see this because I'm watching this, and as a past educator in science, it's tremendous to see what they're going to show us this evening. A lot of times when you're little kids, and I teach preschool right now, which is incredible, and you see these little guys come in with their robots, and they're standing there and pointing everything at you, and it's like, okay, all right, what are they doing? Well, you three definitely are a part of a team that did something similar, but with a lot more value behind it as not just playing, but the educational part and talking about how you're going to put this to use maybe even in your careers, hopefully in your careers down the road. So first of all, I'm going to let Zach talk a little bit about STEM, because I don't know how many people in our viewing audience understand STEM, and then just a little bit about the project, and we're going to go right to this. We have a video to show, a video clip, and we have some pictures. So, Zach, back to you again.
Well, STEM is science, technology, engineering, and math is what the acronym stands for. Basically, what we teach as part of our STEM program at Exeter is really the application of math and science through engineering, and what we do with our students from our introductory class all the way up to our capstone course is we challenge them with real-world design challenges that force them to use their problem-solving skills, their critical thinking skills. We introduce them as ninth graders to the design process, and we teach them how to navigate their way through the design process as a way to improve their problem-solving skills, improve their approach to the problem, so that when they're creating their solutions, they're coming out with better solutions that are more educated, that are based in the criteria that come from the people that are involved with the problem that they're attempting to solve. So these young men, as part of the PA Robotics team for the Technology Student Association Club, their real-world challenge is to build a robot, and the purpose for that robot would be to try to navigate through an area that may be struck by a natural disaster, maybe was hit by an act of terrorism, and it's an area that right now would be too dangerous for humans to try to go in and look for survivors, and so what they're doing is building a robot that can be remote-controlled and brought in to navigate through the rubble and some of the the issues that you may find with a situation like that in order to either maybe save lives, or in this case, what their challenge was to try to turn off a gas main that was represented by a light bulb that they had to turn off with their robot.
OK, Okay, Zach, thank you. And now to the three gentlemen. Let's explain a little bit about the robot that's sitting here on our counter. And all three of you can talk, but not at the same time. But you can share some stories about how you built this, what it came from, you know, so go ahead.
So to start off, we analyzed the problem. Our problem we'd been given was to go through this specific course. We knew the parameters of the course, what it had to do. And we took that information and started with the first task, which was the parallel parking. So our robot had to be able to maneuver very well. So what we did was we made a wheel design that allowed us to move both forward and backwards and side to side without having to turn as much, which allowed us to parallel park well.
I'd like to say something. So last year, we also competed in this competition, and the person who took first at the competition actually used these wheels, and we were all jealous because we wanted to be like that guy. So right away, we told Mr. Parter, we need to order these wheels. So that's where the inspiration of the wheels came from, which allowed us to maneuver through the course very easily.
Right, and like Kevin was saying, we actually had a robot compete in the competition last year, but we obviously did not make it past the regional competition. But this year we came back and we revamped our robot, and we put more emphasis on some of the obstacles we struggled with, and we put them into our robot that would be able to correctly maneuver the course.
So do you want me to explain how, basically, when you're going forward, your wheels are gonna all spin one direction, but these designed wheels, when they spin towards each other, they pull the whole robot this way instead of all the wheels going that way, if that makes sense.
Okay, cool. And Jordan, thank you, and camera here, you're doing a great job showing the public how this is really working here, how they actually put this together. We have a course in front of us. We're gonna experiment with this. Are one of you gentlemen going to put it on the course?
I can probably
just watch your microphone, though. You have your microphone
on. Better range.
You can get that on there. And as they're getting this set up, this is a state-recognized competition where they actually won.
No, we didn't turn it on.
They actually won recognition for this. So it's not just something in the backyard. It's something that they put together and organized and went all the way through to the state recognition. So if it doesn't work, guys, we do have a video clip that you gave me, so we can show the video clip as well. But I'd like to see
It is on. For the battery to run dead. Probably on.
So we actually, Mr. Potter introduced this to us in the second course in the STEM curriculum that we teach at Exeter. And Principles of Engineering. At the end of the class, it was like our final project. Basically, everyone in the class was tasked to build a robot and basically do the same course that would be at a regional competition and state competition. And it really caught our eye. Me and Luke took the class together. It really caught our eye. Mr. Potter wanted us to continue with the Technology Students Club. So the next year, all three of us joined. We got Kyle on board, although he didn't take the class. So. He was very important in the role of this team. So
they have the pictures up now, guys. So, and can you tell us a little bit about where was this competition?
Yeah, so that was what I was going to say next. Our competition, the name of our organization is Technology Students Association, TSA. It's more than just robots. It's more than we would standardly think of when it comes to engineering. There's a lot of competitions. We had a fashion design team that did really well. We had a children's notebook team, children's story team that had to enhance their children's story with technology. And a lot of writing essays. And it's more than just building things. Our team's
documentation.
All in.
Shout out to the rest of the Technology Students Association team.
If you're watching.
Very nice.
Now,
very
one of the things that I would say I'm really proud of this team for is, as they've talked about, they went to the competition last year, they competed, they were not very happy with the way that they finished, and they took it upon themselves to come in basically for an entire year and figure out a way to make sure that they didn't suffer the same failure. So, I mean, that's one of the things, their determination and the way that they just kind of showed their grit and used the motivation of that failure rather than, you know, kind of walking away from it and saying, oh, well, they really took the initiative to come in and really do things on their own. And, you know, the results speak for themselves, being the state champions of Pennsylvania in the PA Robotics competition. So, I mean, I'm really proud of their determination for that and the way that they stuck to it and went out and accomplished a goal that they set for themselves. So.
I think something that's really nice to highlight at this point, too, is when I was teaching and teaching science, kids always want one answer and they're done. But that's not science. So just what happened here this evening so far, you know, you have one problem solved and then what? Another problem or another question comes up from question answered. You have another question. So it's really neat to see that you don't give up. You keep pushing to get that answer or to get that problem solved, which is really a cool idea. I think, Matt, do you have it ready for us in the back room to show the video? We have about a 2-minute, maybe a 3-minute video clip, and there it is. We'll just let you watch this. I don't know if you can hear us.
Right here, what they're doing is parallel parking the robot, which uses the wheels that they were just describing. And this is actually the championship run. This is the run that got them the PA championship. This is loop driving the robot.
So each of those poles you see sticking up, if you knock one of those over, it's a 3-point deduction from your total score. So we'll wait and see if it knocks any over.
This is one of the tougher parts of the competition, trying to get these fallen columns. That's what these PVC pipes on a pivot point represent. It's supposed to be a fallen column in the way of the robot. So this is one of the designs that the guys really did a good job with. You know, their original design utilized a claw instead of the flipper that you see them using here, and you know, through some discussion and just through some practicing on the course, they made the decision to get rid of the claw basically and just use this flipper to get through this part of the course. And that was something that, you know, just based on their trial and error and based on some of the testing that they were able to do, they were able to come up with that idea.
And how long did you have to do that course? Was it a 2-minute, 3-minute course?
We had 3 minutes to get all, well, you got 6 points for, we got 9 points for getting the button and turning off the gas leak, but if you made it back, you got an extra 6 points. You made it back to the start, and we cut it close. We made it just barely on the dot. Like, timer went off the second we got back, so.
Right now, they're trying to turn the light off, which represents the broken gas main that the robot would have to turn off. And then their goal is to navigate their way back through the course and try to get back before that 3-minute timer.
So like Kyle and Kevin were saying earlier, it's not all just about the robot and building. There is also a lot of documentation that went into this. The entire competition was point-based, so there is a notebook that we needed to turn in actually
prior to the
a day prior to the competition, and that was actually worth more points than actually building the robot. So it goes to show you that in engineering there's a lot more to it than just the actual building and driving of the machine.
So do you see this being something that someone could use in the community, like a fire company or some kind of a company that would want to purchase something like this?
With some modifications, I think certainly if you secured everything a little more than this would be a prototype, obviously.
Right.
But if you constructed it in a more
compact,
if we made it more compact, secured everything better, I think it could definitely be something used.
Well, and I would say that this was they did a really good job of doing this for that specific challenge. So you know they did things with this robot just for that specific challenge. Like we talked about the flipper that they used to move the columns. That was something that was specific for this obstacle course. So, you know, it's an example of taking the criteria from the challenge that you're being given, whether it be, you know, the stakeholder groups that are out there in the real world that you're trying to satisfy, the fire departments and things like that, or whether it be the challenge that we're presenting them or that TSA is presenting them. You know, it's just a great example of, again, making sure that they're doing their due diligence. They talked about the notebook. That's something that we teach very heavily in our STEM program. We have lots of kids that are great at getting their hands on things and building, but sometimes the ideas that they come up with to build don't quite solve the problems that we're trying to ask them to solve. So that's one of the things through STEM that we're trying to teach, is that approach to problem solving, not just getting the materials and building right away, but understanding exactly the problem that you're trying to solve, so that when you come up with that solution, as I said previously, it's the best possible solution to solve the problem that you're trying to solve.
So let's go back to the robot itself. Now, you did mention a little bit about the wheels. What is on here? Like, is it, I don't want to say this way, junk? Or is it something you had to purchase? Or how did it come about that you have all the parts where they are?
So this TSA competition, this robotics competition for TSA, was a VEX-sponsored competition. Mm-hmm. And these are all VEX pieces here. It's a type of mechanical robotics system that you can build and put together. So everything we have here is VEX robotics pieces. Mm-hmm. And then Kevin actually, we coded it to the controller and the USBs, which then we connect into a Cortex here, and that way we can drive the robot.
Wow, really nice. And you can see where the science, the technology, the engineering, and the mathematics comes in. Right. So you have to, I don't know if you're in love with all four of those, but you have to be somewhere in between to get to that point. So let's take a few minutes to go away from the robot, but let's talk a little bit about each of you as where you're headed. You're all seniors, correct?
Yes.
So let's start on that end. We'll work this way. And Zach, sorry, you're not a senior.
That's all right. We're here for them.
So let's start with Luke, and come on down and tell us what you're looking at as the future.
Okay, so this fall, I'm actually attending Liberty University in Lynchburg, Virginia, and I will be majoring in mechanical engineering, and I hope to, in the future, hopefully get a job maybe in aeronautics or the military or something with NASA, maybe. So something in that aeronautics field I'd really like to pursue as my future.
Nice.
I, too, am going to be going to Liberty University. I'm taking a different track than Luke is here. What I'm going to be pursuing is aviation. I want to fly planes. And Liberty has an incredible up-and-coming program for that. They're ranked pretty high as a reputable college for aviation. And I'm hoping that after I get all my certifications, I can fly commercial, corporate, maybe do a little bush plane flying.
Wow. Very good. And?
I am attending the Pennsylvania State University to study biomedical engineering. It's more of a specific mechanical engineering major. It's more focused on like medical sides of what mechanical engineering has to offer. So I hope to work on machines like CAT scan machines, mm-hmm. and MRIs and stuff like that. And maybe the other route I was thinking about is like biomechanics, sort of like prosthetic limbs and stuff like that. Maybe helping out in the military with veterans who suffer injuries like of that sort.
Wow. Well, okay, home viewers, now you heard these three right here. And I remember a few years ago I had a young man on that made it big in athletics, and he's doing fairly well in the pros. So right now, though, look at these three, because they're going to do as well, if not even better, with what they're going to go into. So I take my hats off to everybody that's in athletics. I think that's a great way to stay involved, and that's very important. So there's no way we'd be knocking that, but I think this is incredible, the direction you're going to go as well, and how you're going to put together your life, that you're going to be a big help with people all around the country and the world. So let's go back a little bit to Zach, and then I'm going to come back to you three. Zach, talk a little bit about where you came from, you know, some of your background, how you got to where you are in Exeter.
Sure. I've been teaching at Exeter for 10 years. I'm from a small farm town in the mid-state, and I went to Millersville University and was lucky enough to get a job in Exeter, and I've been teaching, like I said, at Exeter High School now for 7 years. I've been in the district for 10, and got involved with STEM education about 5 years ago when some of our administrators asked basically for a volunteer of somebody that wanted to help start a program. And so we began teaching STEM engineering courses through the Project Lead the Way program We were able to purchase some of the VEX kits that we utilize for TSA as well as for our classrooms. I really like what I do at Exeter. I really like teaching STEM. I really think that, you know, these real world applications that the kids get through these problem solving challenges, these design challenges, I think can help connect them and engage them to the learning that they're doing. They can see how they're utilizing science and technology and math and how they all kind of blend together under the umbrella of engineering. These guys got to use the 3D printers that we have at the school to create some parts for their robot, something that we teach in our classes. And so I'm very happy to be a part of it, very happy to be at Exeter, and grateful for great students like these guys who make me look good on a daily basis and are fun to work with. And, it's a great thing that I'm doing with the kids, and I think it's going to be great for their futures. And hopefully, you know, they'll come back and support our program, and we'll continue to have great stories like this coming out of Exeter and coming out of Reading.
And I think another thing too, Zach, that I've found already with the three of these gentlemen with you, and also what I had in my career, is you had to build team. You had to build the respect from within and not be the boss, but be the one that will be the advisor.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's so crucial and important in today's world, to allow kids your age to experience before you're told what to do. Yep. In this kind of a situation. Really quick, I see we're down to about 3 minutes and we had this timed perfectly. So let's start with Kevin. Tell us anything else that you do in school that you want to share with the public.
Okay, so I'm involved in the National Honor Society at our school. I played soccer for 4 years. I was the varsity boys captain this year. I also played tennis for 3 years. And was one of the 5 captains this year for tennis. I was involved with the PA Governor's STEM team, which Mr. Potter also advises. We came second in the county at that competition with Luke and myself and 3 other great people who unfortunately aren't here. I just love the school environment. I like the team aspect of many things, which is, you can tell by sports and stuff like that.
Okay, and before we go on to Kyle and Luke, really quick, there's a shout out to a gentleman out there probably watching us.
Yeah.
Who is that gentleman?
Mr. Lohr is sitting out in the...
Yeah, TA!
Mr. Lohr is our TSA advisor. I'm actually the co-advisor. He's the guy in charge. He does all the nitty-gritty work to make sure that we get to the competitions. And so he's the guy that should be sitting here right now, but he doesn't like to be in front of the camera. So we'll give a shout out to him today.
So we see again, it's down to 2 minutes. Believe it or not, our time's almost up. So I'm going to do a quick run through with Kyle and Luke, and then we'll wrap it up. So go ahead, Kyle.
I'll keep it brief. I'm at the National Honor Society. I'm involved with the bowling team. And just a shout out to the Teachers in the Parks program. I help out with Luke and Kevin from time to time during our summer programs down at Owatonna Creek.
So in high school, I am also involved in the National Honor Society. I have been on the bowling team since I was a freshman. I was the varsity boys and girls captain this past year. I was also involved with the PA Governor STEM program that Kevin and I were a part of, and you know, I just have loved every all the time I've spent at Exeter, and I'm so thankful for Mr. Potter and all the friends and family that I've made over the past 4 years, and Mr. Laura. So it's really just been amazing to be a part of all of it.
And you will take these and cherish these moments.
For sure.
I've been there already, and there's a lot of things that you'll love and you'll be sad to leave, but there'll be another door opening to your future. Visions Federal Credit Union, thank you very much for being a part of sponsoring this show. Thank you to the two gentlemen that are working very hard behind the scenes tonight. That's Matt and Jordan. They're doing a great job with that. And we had 3 moms in the back. I told them they had to be very quiet, and they were good students tonight. So moms, thank you for being here. They did a very nice job with that. Again, anybody that wants to be on this show, please call. BCTV said we can call the studio. You can call them, set it up with them, and just get the information for Dave Renier, and I'm the host, and we'll definitely get to getting your show on or your people on that want to be on. So the 3 of you plus Zach, thank you very much for this evening. I hope that you continue to do what you're doing, and I love teaching and working with kids of all ages, And believe it or not, Zach's probably one of those kids I probably had or had in school, because I'm getting to that point. But I love being out and doing things with kids all over. I think anybody that's watching this show, they might be calling you and saying, hey, I'd like to talk to that gentleman more about what he can do. So with that, have a safe evening, and till next month, good night.
County Kids, City Kids, all the kids that make a difference is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.